good, so cool. Everything, as you can see, we're having fun, man.
What makes Clapton different from other parties?
The population, of course. I mean, the music, the drinks, everything. It's so different, yeah.
Send greetings to your friends.
Shout out to everyone. I can't specify because I have many people I know.
Yo, what's up? What's up?
They have the party after party.
Party after party, bro. What's up?
Hey, how are you doing, man?
I'm okay, bro. How are you doing?
How has been the day for you?
Yeah, it's been a blast, man. Party's working to the maximum. Everything is great.
You go to any university?
Yeah.
Which university?
Moves, of course.
Aha.
Yeah, that's what we're talking.
What makes Moves special from other universities when it comes to partying?
We got all the slaves, man. We know how to party. We know how we do it.
Clubdom, I've been attending since I was at campus, so Clubdom is the real deal. So I encourage everyone out there to attend because Clubdom is the real deal.
What makes Clubdom the real deal?
The real deal, eh? Because me as a person, I think I don't have any difference without so I support the brand, because I take it. Yeah, so far so good, because I've really enjoyed it. Right now I'm chilling because I've really got everything I wanted to get in a dorm. So I'm chilling because I've got everything I really wanted to expect in a dorm. So it's okay, club dorm is the real thing.
What have you enjoyed most in a party?
The ladies are so on point.
It brings out a lot of people of different ways, different trends, different cultures, different behaviors. Like how you can see everybody is composed in their own way. So I would say it's the best feeling you can have on a weekend like this. Like it's pretty fine, nice ladies around, cool dudes having a moment. So it's just a feeling.
Like.
Oh, sorry to them, because I know how campus feels, but this is the moment they should tell their kids about, that Club Dome is the real deal. It's where you be like, you look at a picture 5 years ago, because I've experienced Club Dome from when it came through. So I know it feels to be here. I share memories with my friends, so it's really bad to leave campus without a memory. But I look down and tell my kid, in 2000, this, I was at the Club Dome and it was a blast. I had ballistic nights only. So I would say it's something I would love to have every year. I pretty see everything is available, but I would love them to embrace it in numerous universities out of town. That is maybe to the east or, okay, in the west, they go to Mbarara, but check out numerous districts.
Welcome back to Backstage Pass here on Urban TV. Let's get on with the show. And we take a look at a massive party that went down over the weekend. That was on Saturday at the MTN Warehouse. Club Dome back and one more time, giving us a little something to anticipate for. This time with a little bit of a Caribbean twist to it. The venue opened up at about 3 p.m. on Saturday. A number of people were flocking into the place a little early until the rains came through, disrupted it a little bit. But thankfully, it was completely covered up, pretty much inside the warehouse. So sooner or later, the party started, and the revelers who were in the building managed to kickstart the evening. Later on, it filled up and with pretty much a full house leading into a fantastic evening, as you could see, with a number of people having a great time. Regan joins me on the show today from TVWA. Regan, how are you doing today?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Fantastic. Good to have you on the show. Why a Caribbean edition this time round?
As in, we realized that sometimes people want to go to the beach, people travel far away as they could, but
yeah.
This time we realized, let's bring the thing to the party. We brought the party, and the club dome was that right moment to bring the beach in town.
There are a lot of different aspects of the Caribbean to it. They had very interesting areas where you could take pictures and so forth.
Yeah. And basically the club dome is about students.
Yeah.
So Club B, I saw it very, very probably to bring students together from the different universities to come together and they enjoy what happens around.
Yeah.
So we brought the theme of the beach.
Yeah.
Where we let students come. It's first of all, it's by invites.
Yeah.
We go to the different universities around and we see where we should be and we say, let's bring the Caribbean thing to the people.
You know what? My phone was going crazy on Saturday night when I was at the venue because I posted that I was at Club Dome. A number of people came through and they get to the entrance and they couldn't pay to get in. Why is it only by invite?
It's by invite because we realize that, first of all, we want to bring this experience to the students.
Yeah.
We want to make the students have this vibe. It's by the students, for the students. So we go to the different universities.
Mm-hmm.
We do activations where we ask them what they want to happen.
Yeah.
How they want it to happen,
yeah.
What they really feel is happiness to them. That's where it's usually about what happens there, how they do their things, what they want to do, how do they want it. So basically, it's fun. It's a world within a world.
Speaking about this world within a world, there were a number of entertainers, obviously, that came through. We'll start off with the DJs before we get into the performance. From the DJ side, who was on the decks?
It was DJ Chapati from Tanzania.
Yeah.
The guy did massive, like everyone who was there. Really accepts it was lit.
Yeah.
And we had a drumist also.
Yeah.
Tito Philomy.
Yeah.
The guy was drumming like everything was. I can tell you from the experience I had.
Yeah.
I feel like I can't wait for the next dome.
It was actually very interesting watching him drum alongside the DJ. I hadn't seen that happen before.
Yeah.
Shout out to him for that great performance.
Trust me, those are the talents we want to find in Uganda.
Yeah.
And when you're doing this, we want to see these students get inspired in order to earn what happens around.
Yeah.
And definitely, I can tell you, we are going to do this. The theme is Caribbean.
Yeah.
It's the beach kind of style.
Yeah.
It's the music.
Yeah.
And what is around it. So we are traveling and I can tell you our next stop.
Uh-huh.
People in Mbarara better get ready for us.
All right.
On 25th October.
Yeah.
The Mbarara people, all universities around.
Yeah.
Students.
Yeah.
Wherever you are.
Yeah.
Just come feel this vibe. As you can watch it,
yeah.
You will die with the happiness and the joy.
There was quite a lot of happiness at the venue. What time did it finally end?
It goes on and on as far as it can go.
Yeah.
As long as we are within the law,
yeah.
Everything is lit.
All right, cool. Thank you so much for joining us here on the show. In case you want to follow what exactly happened, you can keep in touch with us. That's at Urban TV Uganda. Also follow the hashtag online, the dome is Caribbean. Moving away from that, when we return in just a short while, we'll find out about a number of people who are traveling away from Kampala. Why are they running away from here? We'll find out about that just in a short while here on Urban TV.
Amazing trips, and we are really looking forward. I'm sure very many of us have done some bookings. I can't say if that's right or not. You can still try your luck and do some bookings as well. Still, we want to thank you, the media, for coming out here to be a part of this. Of course, our main sponsors.
And I must say, we are very, very excited to continue our partnership that we've worked with the Power Guide for a while. Partnership that seeks to celebrate the beauty that we have in Uganda and, you know, go ahead to kind of highlight the good things that we have as a country.
Uganda Travel Month is all about creating great memories like this right across Uganda. This is the month when we celebrate what it means to be Ugandan. And talking about being Ugandan, we talk about something that is made of Uganda. Nothing other than Nile Special. And joining us, we have the brand manager himself, Francis. How are you doing today, Francis?
Good, Denzel. How's it going?
Pretty good, pretty good. Excited about Uganda Travel Month 2019, partnering yet again with the Pearl Guide. What can we expect from this partnership this year?
Well, of course, the Travel Month always brings a lot of exciting stuff with it. It's purely trying to dig into the beauty that we have in Uganda, trying to showcase all the lovely, lovely places we have, our culture, the animals we have in here. And I think that alone brings a lot of excitement, and our consumers can come along and enjoy, you know, one of their favorite brands there.
On a personal level, from the four different locations that we're going to, that is Sese Islands, on to Queen Elizabeth and Mburu, on to Murchison Falls, on to Chobe, which one in particular personally resonates with you?
Personally, I would love to go to the Sese Islands. I mean, it's always good to get away, you know, to an island and, you know, just disconnect from all the chaos we have in town. But on a more purposeful angle, I think I'd be very excited to be at the Murchison's.
You know, we decided. You see how the past editions have been with, you know, people having fun and everyone wanting to join this edition. We decided, let's turn up the heat. Let's bring more DJs. Let's bring more fun so that there's a whole experience, not just, you know, waiting to reach the destination and then you have a blast. The party is starting. The moment you get onto the bus like this, the party begins.
Party after party from Kampala onto the four destinations now. There's Jin, I beg your pardon. There's Sese Island. There's Murchison Falls. There's Chobe, there's QE, that's Queen Elizabeth, as well as the infamous fourth place, which just happens to be Lake Mburu. Yeah, my math, my geography terrible. From the four of them, which one are you excited about?
If I had my way, I would go to all of them. But maybe I'll go to Murchison Falls. Yes.
Why that one, though?
I'm looking forward to the adventure. I want to go further than I've been. So,
We all have our different ones that we're looking forward to. Which one are you looking forward to? Keep in touch on social media. The hashtag is UG Travel Month.